Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hi students, in this session we are going to discuss another general methods of preparation of the carboxylic acid. Already in my previous class I completed four preparations method, hydrolysis process. These are all already completed in previous class. Now see here, in this session remaining chemical remaining preparation methods of carboxylic acids are discussed. See here, from Grignard reagent from Grignard reagent, how we will prepare carboxylic acid from the Grignard reagent. See here statement, Grignard reagent reacted with carbon dioxide to yield magnesium carboxylate, to form the magnesium carboxylate. These on as acidification. Which one is acidification? Magnesium carboxylate is acidification, produced carboxylic acid. So from the Grignard reagent it can easily to prepare carboxylic acid. See here in the mechanism, this is carbon dioxide, CO2, C double bond O, again C double bond O, Grignard reagent with alkyl magnesium halide in the presence of the dry ether. What product is obtained in the intermediate position? Magnesium carboxylate. This is the magnesium carboxylate. In this mechanism point of view, my dear students, here the pi electron migrated to oxygen side, hence here negative charge is formed, here carbocation is formed. Now from the Grignard reagent, the cleavage between alkyl group and magnesium halide, upon alkyl group get nucleophile, this is a positive. So after that they are connected to carbon and oxygen. This is the intermediate product, magnesium carboxylate. After this magnesium carboxylate, acidification. So here H plus is attacked to the magnesium carboxylate. Finally RCOOH. So it is nothing but acid group, carboxylic acid group, and additionally MgxOH is formed. MgxOH is formed. This is the entire the preparations method of carboxylic acid from Grignard reagent. Now here above equation is a general representation equation. Now see here Coulomb, it's a example, one of the example, methyl magnesium bromide. This is called methyl magnesium bromide, CH3MgBr, is a best Grignard reagent, methyl magnesium bromide treated with carbon dioxide in the presence of dry ether. This is the intermediate product, additional product, this is a intermediate additional product. Again he is acidifications with water or hydrolysis with water, and finally acetic acid and MgOH X is formed. X is nothing but here bromine, bromide, okay ma. So this is a very important preparations method of carboxylic acid with the help of the Grignard reagent. Now in this statement, na, when carbon dioxide is bubbled or dry ice through a central ethanol solution of the Grignard reagent, finally carboxylic acids are obtained. So here important point, whenever you will prepare carboxylic acid with help of the Grignard reagent, carbon dioxide is a must. Carbon dioxide is must. Now see here one more statement. The carbonation of alkyl lithium, this is most important, the carbonation of alkyl lithium is similar to the Grignard reagent, is similar to the Grignard reagent. My dear students, instead of the Grignard reagent, it can use alkyl lithium. So here, instead of the Grignard reagent, CH3Li is there. It's nothing but methyl lithium. So methyl lithium is there, alkyl lithium. So this alkyl lithium, whenever treated with carbon dioxide in the presence of the dry ether, finally acetic acid is also obtained. So most important point right now here, my dear students, instead of Grignard reagent, if Grignard reagents is not present here, instead of the Grignard reagent, alkyl lithium is also used. The alkyl lithium, it can easily to directly treated with carbon dioxide and carboxylic acid is also formed. Additionally, lithium hydroxide is also formed. This is the most important another preparation method instead of the Grignard reagent. Okay, ma? So carboxylic acid, it can easily to prepare with the help of the Grignard reagent with the combination of the carbon dioxide and presence of the dry ether. This is the preparation method of the carboxylic acid with the help of the Grignard reagent. Next, sixth preparation method of carboxylic acid. This is the most important preparation method, and from alkenes. This is generally carbonylation of alkenes or Koch reaction. It's a very, very familiar reaction, my dear students. Preparations of carboxylic acid from the alkenes is generally name is a Koch reaction. See, my dear students, in this reaction, when a mixer of alkenes and carbon monoxide and steam is heated under pressure approximately 573 kelvins to 673 kelvin in the presence of catalyst such as phosphoric acid, phosphoric H3PO4, phosphoric acid, monocarboxylic acid is formed. Monocarboxylic acid is formed. This is commonly known as the Koch reaction. One more named reactions came in this category, Koch reaction. Listen very carefully. Koch reactions is nothing but is the preparation of the carboxylic acid with the help of the alkenes, unsaturated hydrocarbon such as alkenes. Okay, ma'am? Now here important point is which one is act as a catalyst here. Phosphoric acid is act as a catalyst where in the Koch reaction. Now see here one example, CH2 double bond CH2, it's ethene, additional treated with carbon monoxide and water in the presence of the phosphoric acid, and finally what product is obtained, my dear student? Propanoic acids are obtained. CH3 CH2 COOH is obtained. Okay, you know here from the H plus OH minus is there. Here you know the mechanism, I am very clearly explained in my previous example how to going on the mechanism whenever you will prepare the carboxylic acid. So the same mechanism also you will be continuing the same chemical reaction also. And one more example, propene. Propene CH3, here CH double bond CH2 and plus carbon monoxide and water in the presence of the phosphoric acid, and finally here 2 methyl propanoic acids are formed. 2 methyl propanoic acid, here pressure is 623 kelvins pressure. And most important key point from this preparation method, this is a recent method of making carboxylic acid. Underline this point, ma. Koch reaction is a recently introduced this reaction. Whenever you will prepare the carboxylic acid, monocarboxylic acid, especially monocarboxylic acid, this is a moderated method. So this is a recent method of making carboxylic acid, and this acid catalyzed hydrocarboxylation, that is a acid catalyzed hydrocarboxylation of alkenes, it's called Koch reaction. Keep it in your mind, ma. Koch reaction is a moderated reaction to preparation of the carboxylic acids. So now six preparations methods are successfully completed, and now we are going to discuss one more preparation method of carboxylic acid from the alkynes. See, my dear students, you know that very well, alkynes, It is a triple bonded hydrocarbons. All kinds on ozonolysis on oxidation gives carboxylic acid. Direct statement here. All kinds are involved in the ozonolysis process through the oxidation gives the carboxylic acid. See here the general representation equation, my dear students. R is nothing but alkyl group, C triple bond C, or now ozonolysis in the presence of the hydrogen peroxide. So two different type of acids are obtained, and instead of ozonolysis, and you can use the KMnO4 also. KMnO4 is also, it is easily to prepare the carboxylic acid. That is another important preparations method of the carboxylic acid. My dear student, in this preparation method, substituted alkenes actually seen here. Ozonolysis with alkynes, that is the most important. Instead of ozone, you can use the KMnO4 also. Now see here, Kela, our equations are there. C2H5, C triple bond C, CH3, 3 oxygens and water, and finally these are the product C2H5COOH, CH3COOH. Okay ma, this is from alkynes. But important key point, my dear students, from alkene, whenever carboxylic acids are prepared from the alkene, that is has one particular named reaction, that is called Koch reaction. Okay ma. And another important one, from gem trihalide, from the gem trihalides, you know, gem trihalide, 3 halogen groups are present with carbon. So continuously attaches to the 3 halogen group through one carbon, that is generally named gem trihalide. My dear students, carboxylic acid, it can easily to prepare the from the gem trihalide, and also my dear students, gem dicarboxylic acids also. So see here, gem trihalides on hydrolysis to give acid. Direct equation, C6H5CX3, in the presence of, these are the optimum conditions, and finally acids are obtained. This is the general preparation methods of the carboxylic acid by using of gem trihalides. So here C6H5CCl3, either alkali also, instead of the water you can use the alkali also, finally acids are obtained. These are the generally aliphatic carboxylic acid category preparations, up to 7 preparation method. Now we are going to discuss alkyl benzene. It's a aromatic carboxylic acid preparation method. It's also important, my dear students, aromatic carboxylic acid preparations method. Here in the aromatic carboxylic acid preparations method, first one is the from alkyl benzene, from the alkyl benzene. Now see here, CH3, you know, this is a alkyl benzene, alkyl group and benzene group, alkyl benzene, in the presence of this optimum condition, so acid group is obtained, aromatic acid groups are obtained. Now here one more examples are given here. See now, CH2CH3. So this is a ethyl benzene, in the presence of 6 moles, 6 oxygen atoms are nothing but here 2O3. So KMnO4, now additional product, this is the benzoic acid, additionally carbon dioxide and water also obtained. Water is also obtained. This is generally aromatic carboxylic acid preparation method. Generally aromatic carboxylic acid preparation method from the alkyl benzene. In the alkyl place, instead of methyl you will put ethyl or propyl, whatever it, that is a ever vishma. Okay nana. And see now, 9th one nana, from malonic esters. It's also very very important preparation method, malonic esters. From the malonic ester, it can easily to prepare the acid. It can easily to prepare the acid. So now see here, CH2 sinana, CH2COO, C2H5, again COO, C2H5. After that, reaction mechanism ungalukku theriyumo. So this one is converted into SN2 reaction. Finally these products are obtained. This one finally, this is the final product, this is a hydrolysis with KOH, intermediate product is obtained. This intermediate product again treated with water, finally acids are obtained. So this is not required, but in board level is not required, and NEET level is also important. So all preparations methods, up to here 9 preparations method I discussed, all preparations methods are very very important, especially my dear students, hydrolysis. What chemicals are hydrolysis generally? From the cyanide group, amides, anhydrides, esters, and acid chlorides, alcohol. These are all from these chemicals, and carboxylic acid preparation methods are romba important ma. Okay na? Now last and final one is the heating of sodium alkoxide with carbon monoxide. Heating of sodium alkoxide with carbon monoxide. See, listen my dear students, by the action of carbon monoxide on heating at 423 kelvins with sodium alkoxide under pressure, sodium salt of the carboxylic acid is obtained, which on treatment with acid finally carboxylic acid are obtained. Okay ma, this is the entire statement. Now see here, sodium alkoxide, this is the sodium alkoxide treated with carbon monoxide in the presence of 423 kelvins and under pressure, and what happened here, sodium salt is obtained, RCOONA, sodium salt is obtained. This is again treated with diluted HCl, and finally acid groups are obtained. Here one example is there, sodium alkoxide. This is a sodium alkoxide treated with carbon monoxide and under pressure, and sodium acetate is obtained, and additionally treated with HCl, finally acetic acids are obtained. These are the general preparations methods of the carboxylic acid from the different type of the categories, Grignard reagent, alkenes, alkynes, gem trihalides, alcohol, acid anhydrides, amides, etc. etc. Okay ma, now I successfully completed the entire preparations method of the carboxylic acid. Now we are going to discuss and physical properties of the carboxylic acid. Hi students, now we are going to discuss physical properties of carboxylic acid, but unfortunately I didn't written physical properties on board, just I explain orally. So listen very carefully every students, physical properties of the carboxylic acid. In the physical properties of carboxylic acid, first one is a physical state. You know, the first three aliphatic acids are colorless, pungent smelling liquid. Important point, write down. The first three aliphatic acids are colorless, pungent smelling liquid. The next six members, it means C4 to C9, from C4 to C9s are oily liquid with an odor of the rancid butter. Rancid butter, underline this point. The first three aliphatic acids are generally colorless, pungent smelling liquid. The next six members, it means from C4 to C9s are oily liquid with an odor of the rancid butter. Thereafter, the higher members are colorless, it means above 10 carbon atoms are generally colorless and odorless, waxy solids. It's most important nana. Here 1, 2, 3 nana, 1, 2, 3 carbon number of the carboxylic acid, especially aliphatic carboxylic acids, are pungent smelling liquids, and C4 to C9 also oily liquid with rancid butter smell. And after C10, it's nothing but higher members of carboxylic acids are generally colorless, odorless, waxy solid. For example, my dear students, benzoic acid and most of the other aromatic acids are colorless and crystalline solids. Colorless, crystalline solid. This is the physical states of the carboxylic acid. Next, second one is, second physical properties, solubility. So solubility point of view, listen every student, solubility, among the aliphatic acid, the first four, it means C1 to C4, among the aliphatic acid, the first four C1 to C4 members are fairly soluble in water, and the solubility decreases gradually with the rise of the molecular mass. Yes, clear that. You know the, my dear student, from initial aliphatic carboxylic acids, it means from C1 to C4 member of the carbon atom of the aliphatic carboxylic acids are fairly soluble in water. But in higher member of the carbon atom, you know that very well, number of the carbon atoms are increases, molecular mass also increases. If the molecular mass increases, solubility is also decreases gradually with the rise of the molecular mass. However, all are soluble in alcohol and ether. That is a most important point. All carboxylic acid groups, either low member carbon or higher member carbon, generally soluble in alcohol and ethers. And benzoic acid is sparingly soluble in the cold water, but is soluble in hot water. Sparingly means, you know, that moderately soluble in the cold water, but highly soluble in the hot water. Which one? Benzoic acid. Benzoic acid na aromatic carboxylic acid. So aromatic carboxylic acid sparingly soluble in cold water, and general soluble in the hot water, and alcohol and ether also. So benzoic acid sparingly soluble in the cold water, and normal soluble in the hot water, and also soluble in the alcohol and ether. These are the solubility. Why some carboxylic acid soluble in the water, what based? Because intermolecular hydrogen bondings are present in between of the carbonyl group C double bond O, OH. Here hydrogen bonds are there, na? So that's why they are easily to soluble in the water. So that is the most important point, my dear students. Hydrogen bonds are present here, that's why they are easily to soluble in the water. So again, I'll repeat this same statement. The solubility of the lower member is due to the hydrogen bonding, which the carboxylic oxygen form hydrogen bond with the hydrogen atom of the water, and hydroxyl hydrogen form hydrogen bond with the oxygen atom of water. That is the reason they are soluble in the water. Okay, ma? This is the solubility and physical state. And third physical properties is boiling point. It's a very important boiling point. Boiling point of the carboxylic acid increases regularly with increasing of molecular mass. Boiling point of carboxylic acid are higher than those of alcohol of same molecular mass. This is due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding between two acid molecules. This is a most important point, my dear students. Once again, I repeated. Boiling points of the carboxylic acids increases regularly with increasing of molecular mass. Boiling point of carboxylic acids are higher than those of the alcohol of same molecular mass. This is due to the intermolecular hydrogen bonds between two acid molecules. Do you have any doubt about this hydrogen bonding structure? Just check it out in your CBSE test book. In between of the carboxylic acid contains the hydrogen bonds. Okay, ma? This is the boiling point of the carboxylic acid. And last and final one is the melting point. See, my dear students, the melting point of the aliphatic carboxylic acid do not show a regular pattern. In first 10 members of the homologous series, the oscillations or alternations effect is observed. That is the most important key point in the melting point of view. In case of the homologous series of carboxylic acid, the oscillations or alternations effect is present here. The melting point of an acid with even number of the carbon atom is higher than the next lower and next higher acid with odd number of the carbon atoms. These are the fourth melting points. So see, my dear students, physical state, solubility. What is the reason of carboxylic acid easily to soluble in the water? Due to the presence of the hydrogen bonding, and boiling points and melting points also. Okay, ma? These are the physical properties. In my next class, I will be continue the most important part chemical properties of the carboxylic acids. You know, in carboxylic acid structure point of view, I am very clearly to be explained C double bond O and OH. C double bond O, OH. Here, hydroxyl group from alcohol and carbonyl group from the carbonyl compound, C double bond O, OH. So, if some students are thinking, sir, carboxylic acid group generally obtained from the combination of the carbonyl group and hydroxyl group, but their properties are similar to carbonyl group such as aldehyde and ketone or alcohol? Never, because these are obtained from the combination of the carbonyl compound and hydroxyl group, but it has a separate properties. COOH acid group has separate properties, is not a similar properties of the aldehydes and ketones. It's clear, ma? So now I successfully completed the general preparations method of the carboxylic acid and physical properties. In my next class, I will be continue the chemical properties. Okay, ma?